to make this a thing? Why does it feel like we're working? You act like a whole different person. I'm tired of searching.
So we have a crazy start to our morning because we're gonna fly on a helicopter, that one over there. And it's something I've wanted to do since last year when we came to Cape Town, because Cape Town is just so breathtaking. So I can only imagine what it looks like from up there. And we have our friends here with us, Janya and Masha. Hi guys, they're coming with us as well. The pilot is waiting for us. We're gonna
go
now.
Whoa, it's a nice one.
Hey, can you hear me?
I can, no, yeah, I don't have mine.
Oh, on. Yeah, you don't have
mine. Oh, should I put it on?
You can put it on, yeah.
Okay, cool. You look cool. You have a really good look.
My friend Naila, who arrived in Cape Town
the day before yesterday. It was at night.
But literally she arrived at like 12:30 at night. And yeah, I'm so excited to show you Cape Town.
Oh, I'm so excited myself. It's a dream come true.
So what do you have to say now that you've been here for a day? Like, what's your first impression of Cape Town? I feel like I live
summer,
here by the way.
When it's winter where we live, summer just smells like summer. As soon as you step out of the plane, just the breeze, oh, so nice.
So Naila, where are we going right now?
We're going to Bokap. It's a very picturesque area.
Colorful.
in Cape Town. So I have a picture from that area in my vision board.
This is a crazy true story.
Back from December 2017. I didn't even know it was Cape Town. And now I'm here, so we're gonna go and find the place of that picture.
The exact spot that was on the
vision board. So I can put it next to my vision board, which is absolutely surreal. I tripped and fell into a rhythm with you. I jumped off the deep end, but still played it cool.
Guys, check this out. So this right here is the car and the buildings. Like, these two were on the vision board that Naila had.
We passed by here this morning and my jaw just dropped.
Because you recognize it, right? This is crazy. We're gonna go take some pictures right there of you, and then you can go and post
the blue
it.
Car is there.
Even the blue car, maybe just like permanently parked in that spot.
I'm so happy for you. I can't believe it. This is such an emotional moment for some reason.
Many more dreams come true.
This is amazing.
That's why I honestly, guys, I believe in vision boards so much. It's happened to me so many times when I would put something on my vision board and then the exact same thing, you guys know this, I've talked about it so many times, comes true. That's why be careful what you wish for. That's another note.
Wish big.
Okay, let's go take some pictures now.
Hi. What are you eating? Are you having a cucumber or a strawberry? What was that? Is it yummy? Yeah? Can I have a cucumber too? Alexa.
Try to swim?
Not really. I just tried to go in like to my waist and I didn't really succeed because I could only go to like the like where the lower part of my bikini starts basically. Oh, oh my god. Alexa, what are you doing? On the way to Chapman Peaks Drive, and this is actually our second attempt. Nyla is in the back there, super excited, regardless of whether we get an epic sunset or not. Right. Alex is kind enough to drive, as always, on the other side of the car.
Which probably seems like the real side, because you know the camera mirrors things.
Doesn't
sometimes. Mirror? I think so, yeah.
I don't know, but to me it's still so strange to sit on this side of the car. Like basically this should be the driver's seat, but it's not. Anyways, so yeah, yesterday we tried to drive to Chapman's Peak Drive and then the sun was setting and then it literally set behind the clouds before it actually was supposed to set, and then it got really, really dark, so we never ended up driving fully to Chapman's Peak. So I'm super excited because it's looking like it could be a good sunset today, and Alex and I have already been there a couple of times, actually probably three, four times this trip. And it's one of the most beautiful drives, I would say, that I've been on. I think overall, it's in the top five drives ever in the world. And it's truly breathtaking. You act like a whole different person. I'm tired of searching. I know it's only a matter of time till the sun rays up. Cause I'm all out of words, feel alone every time we talk. Light is just so incredible. There's like a beautiful gradient in the sky. Nayla got lucky. It was the perfect sunset because these kind of sunset actually linger for a long time.
Yeah,
when
yeah.
The sky is mostly clear, there's not a lot of clouds. It just looks unreal. Come with getting older. We finished out, but we had our day. Now your disguise is fading. Your disguise is fading away.
Man, I had to join the party.
So we're about to head out for dinner. Alex, are you ready?
Yes, packing up.
Yeah, okay, perfect. So
it's a rainy day here in Cape Town.
It's the first day here. We've been here for almost 6 weeks. It's our sixth week now, and we're leaving in a few days now. But it's the first day I felt cold here. Maybe the weather just wants me to get ready for the cold that we've been having in London. This has been probably one of the coldest winters we've had in 5 years in London. I'm glad we missed most of it. But anyways, yeah, we're heading up back on Thursday, and tonight we're having a farewell dinner for Naila because she's going back to London tonight. Her flight is at midnight, and we're also meeting up with our friends that we made here. That's one great thing that came out of this trip. Actually, we made some new friends, and those of you guys who are active on YouTube, you might know them. It's Fun for Louis, so Louis from Fun for Louis YouTube channel, and his beautiful girlfriend Raya. You guys are gonna meet them as well. They booked some restaurant that they really loved, so we're gonna be going there. Yeah, I'm just really excited to hang out with them because it's probably the last time we're gonna see them before we leave. And every time we've met with these guys, we had such amazing conversations and so many laughs, and it's just so great to make new friends that you can go really deep with. Okay, we have to really go now. We're gonna be late. Naila's suitcase, Naila's vlogging as well.
I can't believe it either. I want to live here.
Hi. It's so amazing to see you both.
Yeah, look at this delicious food.
Baby girl!
Love you,
thank you so much, Naila.
I can't believe it's over.
It's crazy. I can't believe we live together. As long as you be my
girl. You guys are in focus, so that's great. Alright, so the evening has come to an end. And as I was saying earlier when I was vlogging before, that one of the best things that came out of this trip is actually making new friends and like meeting you guys. Alex met you before, Louis, I know.
Yeah. But briefly, like, we had a
yeah, us like meeting so many times and having so many amazing conversations and like
going. Especially tonight, we're the last
one. Yeah, there's almost. Like literally almost nobody else in the restaurant. So what we usually do during our dinners is like we do a lot of questions. Oh, and I would have to say Raya is like, that's her specialty. She always comes with lots of questions. But I want to finish off this vlog with a question for you guys. Maybe like a tip for people and for myself as well. Because one of my goals this year is to make more friends.
Okay.
So like what's your tip for making more friends? Or like making new friends in your life?
Oh, I've got one.
Okay, would you like to go first then?
Yeah, go on then. I think for me, something I've had to discipline myself on is like, I find it quite easy to talk about myself, but I feel like that's not a good way to make friends.
Absolutely.
I like love the challenge of like trying to get someone to talk from heart, so where they're passionate. So I kind of, like I want to hear like, I mean, you can just ask like, what are you passionate about? But that kind of vibe where you're like really trying to get them excited about talking to you about themselves, and I feel like that's when you start like that real conversation. Anyway, there's a one tip.
I think that's great. I agree. And mine is related to what you were saying before. I don't know where this question thing came from.
Yeah.
And it could be like just if you go, you know, you're gonna go to a party or something, come with a few questions ready. Now it just comes naturally to me where I just like someone's talking, I'm like, oh, that's a good question to ask.
Yeah,
but for me, it's I just don't have time for small talk, and if you go in deep from the beginning, then you can like really connect to people and find things that you have in common, and that's where like friendships really, like that's the base for friendships, I think. So you can have a whole conversation of small talk with someone and then walk away and be like, I don't really know who they are or if we have anything in common. But if you can talk about, like your dreams and fears and like deep stuff from the beginning, then you have the base for what can hopefully be a strong friendship.
Oh, and put your phone away, turn it off, or just put it in your pocket, like turn it upside down, don't get distracted. That's my like, that's the relationship damager for me.
Amazing advice. Yeah.
But also I just want to say that for us, like you guys being in Cape Town at the same time as us has totally made our trip. So,
thank you.
Yeah, we're so grateful. I know.
We'll meet on the some other side of the
world. Yeah, we'll be crossing paths again very soon.